Now that we have some basic understanding of NLP or natural language processing, let's see what is an NLP toolkit, or in short NLTK. So NLTK is a suite of open source tools created to make NLP processes in Python easier to build. So in the last video we had seen that NLP has revolutionized many areas, like it may be parts of speech tagging, it may be sentence translation, it may be even text generation and many more applications. So there are many inbuilt functions and libraries that are included inside this NLTK library. So you don't need to implement everything from scratch. For example, we may have a stem function inside this. So what it does is, if you have many words like coder, maybe coding, maybe coders, and many more, then it all comes down to these all words are stemmed to their root word, like code. So you can write a complex library to do all of these, but it's already present in NLTK and you don't need to do anything. Similarly for word separation, so given a sentence or a text, you want to tokenize it into a list of words. So you don't need to write a custom function of yourself. You can just use the tokenized function there. And similarly, there are many more things like stop words and many more applications which are inbuilt in NLTK, and many more are being added continuously due to its open source nature. So it's a very useful library, and if you don't know how to use it, then anything you want to design or develop will be very slow, because you will need to do everything yourself. Now let's start with the setup for the NLTK. So first you need to install the NLTK. So for more details you can visit the official NLTK website, and you can see the installation instructions for Linux, Mac or Windows as per your system. And once you have done that, you can import this using import NLTK. And if you don't get any error after installation and you do import NLTK, and then you are fine to go, because you did not get any error. Now, once you have installed it and imported NLTK in your Python code, you can download it and explore the package. So once you write NLTK.download, some UI will come, downloader UI, and it will give you some list of packages. And if you are doing it in Google Colab notebook, then it will again be some this kind of list, like D for download, L for list. So you can list the packages using L, and whatever package you want to download, you can write D and then package identifier, and it will download that. So if you are using Google Colab, then you can write D all and it will download all the packages. But if you are using it from your native command line or IPython notebook or Jupyter notebook, then it will give a downloader UI, and from there you can select the package and then click download. I will show that after some time. So first let's see. And then once you have done downloading, you want to see what are the available functions and attributes present in this package. You can write dir nltk. So you need to import that, then download, and then it will pop out a list of various functions like stem. As I have explained, this is called stemming because it stems these words to their root words, and then tokenized, and then POS tag, it stands for parts of speech tagging. And there will be tons and tons of these functions, and I cannot go through all of these in this video series, but you can explore as much as you want. Many of them will be useful for the application you are trying to build. Then let's see one custom example of this tokenize function. So this is just to give you a flavor of how to use the various components of NLTK. So first you will import it, as we have done already. And then from nltk.tokenize, we import word tokenize. So this will tokenize a sentence into a list of words. So for example, if you have an input text, I am learning NLP and using NLTK, and then you use this word tokenize on this input text, then it will return. So this word tokens will become a list which will contain all the words. So I am, and so on till NLTK. So it has tokenized the words and returned a list of that. So when you print input text, it will be this sentence. When you print word tokens, it will be a list. So let's see all of this in a Jupyter notebook. So first I will do import NLTK. So I have already installed NLTK on my system. So if you haven't installed, or then you will get an error if you do import NLTK. So first you need to do pip install NLTK, and then you can import this library. So when I go ahead and run it, I don't get any error. That means it's installed. Now I'd like to download the packages and explore what's inside that. So I will run this, and this was the UI I was talking about. So you will get all the packages lists. So let's say I select all packages, and then I can do download. So it's downloading all the packages. So you can cancel, or so I will pause this video and come back when it's downloaded. Now we see that all the packages have been downloaded. So we can quit this window, and we get a true here. Now let's explore it, and we will do dir NLTK, and this should list out all the various functions we have been talking about. So you can find here like POS tag for parts of speech tagging, and similarly we had this stem function for stemming, and we will have tokenize another ready-made functions available here. Now let's write our tokenize example. So let's insert a heading here. Tokenize example. And now let's write our code. So we will write from NLTK dot tokenize import word tokenize, and then we will have input txt, and this is I am learning NLP and using NLTK. So this is the input text. So let's tokenize it and save it in word tokens. And then we will use the word tokenize function on the input text. So, and let's run it. So we get some error. Input txt is not defined. Sorry, there is spelling mistake. Run again. And now let's print it. Print input txt, and also print the word tokens. So we see that this is the input sentence, and the word token contains a list of words. So this just two lines of code using this NLTK's ready-made function word tokenize. You have tokenized this entire sentence. So that's why you can see how much powerful this NLTK is, and you can see here the extensive list of all the functions available. So that was just a brief introduction to NLTK. So in further videos we will see more about NLTK in Python. Thank you.